All right, so a great way for us to understand a little bit more how the triangular trade worked and this idea of mercantilism work is just to look at this map here. And so, well, first thing we're going to look at is I want you to notice where the 13 colonies are there on the North American continent. You can see the area of green. There's the 13 colonies. A few other areas you need to be familiar with and understand. This is the West Indies, what is known as at that time as the West Indies. Over here we have England in particular and the rest of Europe. And down here, partially covered up by the legend, is Africa. And so leaving the 13 colonies, we have several different raw materials usually that leave the colonies. And you'll notice these are primarily raw materials. So leaving the colonies headed to England is fish, whale oil, lumber, and tobacco. Leaving the colonies, in particular New England area, is rum, iron products, going to Africa, and then flour, fish, meat, and lumber going from the colonies again to the West Indies. And these, we actually are, what we're going to see is two different triangular trade routes here. One of them, let's just continue to see. Look, and so we've got England. Now let's see what is leaving England and Europe and where it goes. Okay, so you can notice, as you see here, leaving England and headed back to the colonies are teas, spices, furniture, cloth, and tools. And the thing you'll notice here, these are manufactured items primarily. These are prepared items. Teas and spices even have to have a certain amount of prep that is done to them before they're actually ready. You don't just pick it off of the plant and it's ready to be brewed as tea or used as a spice. And then furniture obviously is manufactured, cloth is manufactured, and that's one of the most important manufacturing industries in England, which is also called the textile industry. And so then also leaving England, though, you see iron products, and those are also going to Africa. And then you probably have a good idea what's going to be coming from Africa. Obviously, we know slaves is going to be coming from Africa. And you can see there kind of they've got several different locations here that all along the coast, the west coast of Africa, straight from Africa to the West Indies. And the other thing to recognize what this territory is called, what all of this is called, and this is called, this route is known as the Middle Passage. This passage was a horrible trip from Africa to the West Indies. Men and women packed on these boats like cattle, treated as animals more than they are treated as people. And there were significant numbers of deaths that were a result of this trip. The people that were slave traders had to have just absolutely their hearts. It's hard to imagine people doing this, one group of people doing this to another group of people, but they did. Their hearts had to be very hardened to what they were actually doing. You're probably sitting, before that you were thinking, but I was pretty sure we had slaves in the colonies as well, and absolutely we did. But most of those slaves didn't come straight directly from Africa. They came from Africa, but they first were in the West Indies. And so molasses and sugar are taken, along with their slave cargo, are taken to the colonies. And so you actually see here, you see kind of two different triangular trade routes developing here. So we've got this triangular trade that goes from the colonies to England, England to Africa, and then Africa to North America. And so this is kind of, this whole area is kind of treated as one point, one of the 3 points on your triangle. But you also see another triangle here. You see a few goods coming directly from the colonies to Africa, then from Africa to the West Indies, slaves and gold, and then from the West Indies up to North America, or to the 13 colonies. And so you can see we've got two different triangular trade routes, and both of these are supporting mercantilism. Primarily this one that we have here is a mercantilism, follows the theory of mercantilism that we just talked about. So this is the triangular trade, and these are the products that are being shipped.